This year, dotted all around Islamabad, we have these exhibition boards with photographs on them, and each one covering a different theme around Jalsa. This first one covers the international abayats from previous years and listing the numbers of people that have joined the community. We see from 1993, when only 204,000 people joined, the progression, the exponential growth, through to last year when 81 million people joined. And we have photographs from the various international abayat ceremonies. This one shows the activities from the United States of America Jamaat. And here we see various scenes from the host country, the United Kingdom Jamaat. I have with me now Mr. Mansoor Ahmad Shah, who is the chief editor of the Review of Religions. The Review was actually started 100 years ago under the auspices of the Promised Messiah, alayhi salam. Mansoor Shah, given that this is a special year for the Review, can you please give us some information about the Review?
Yes, the Review of Religion was an English magazine which commenced under the auspices of the Promised Messiah, alayhi salatu wasalam. He was deeply concerned with the English people and the English-speaking world, and he wanted to set up a magazine which spoke to these people. For almost a year, this project continued. Fortunately, during this time, Muhammad Ali, who had been nominated as the editor, he was able to translate a number of extracts from the Promised Messiah's writings, and he was able to put these ones down in the first magazine, which started in January 1902. So this year marks the centenary of the issue. We're going to be coming out with a formal edition, centenary edition in December, meanwhile, you see, we have been celebrating and we've been trying to repeat some of the history which the initial edition captured. So some of the articles which came in the initial edition are being reproduced by us in the current editions. The Review of Religion is also being simultaneously published also in Ghana, Nigeria and India. And a lot of work also is done in America, where they microfilm it and, you know, preserve it, and they keep it on the CD, and it's available on the internet.
And roughly nowadays, what is the circulation of the Review of Religions?
In the UK, we publish 5,000. A lot of it is sent. Some of it goes to the UK, some of it to Europe, and some to America and Canada. And in addition to that, the magazine which is published in Nigeria and Ghana is circulated locally. The one in India is circulated locally. We're trying to establish contacts in Indonesia so that they can start a review down there. There's a version which is published in French also, you know, which is published in for the African countries.
I see. Yes. So it's a truly global publication.
Yes.
Over the years, there have been some changes to the Review in the format and the publication. Can you talk us through some of those?
Yes. Initially, when the magazine started, they used to reproduce a whole set of books. So the philosophy of teaching of Islam initially started off being reproduced in various chapters, and each edition featured one or two chapters. But subsequently, the articles have got shorter because the readers were not able to, you know, keep up pace with a full version of a book. So the articles are now getting shorter and much punchier this way. We've tried to retain a format where we have a note in common, which is typical during that time, and an editorial. Then we have some extracts from the writings of the Promised Messiah, and some theme, you know, one or two themes, you know, which are developed on something which is topical at that time.
Yes. And recently, with the demise of Bashir Ahmad Orchard Sahib,
yes,
who was a former editor,
yes,
of the review, it leads me to, can you talk us through the notable personalities that have contributed and worked on the review?
Yes. Ones which come immediately to mind, obviously, are Bashir Ahmad Orchard, who sadly passed away. He served the Review of Religion diligently over 9 years, nine long years, and he is the one, you know, instrumental in bringing very short articles into the review, and extremely spiritual, and a lot of young people have been stimulated by his articles. His articles on Life Supreme have now been reproduced, guideposts have been reproduced as separate books. In addition, after that, we had Mr. Bashir Rafiq, who managed it for some time, and then also Mr. Rafiq Ahmad Hayat, who is now the Amir of the Jamaat UK. So I took over from him only last year, at the end of the year, because his work had become so much in the Emirates, in the UK. And we've been trying to catch up so that we are able to reproduce each edition on time. We are now gradually catching up, but the most stimulating side of it is that the Promised Messiah wanted at least 10,000 editions published, 10,000 readers. Mm-hmm. And we are trying to, through this Jalsa and through an awareness campaign in America and Canada, to get hold of these 10,000 readers as soon as possible. A lot of readers, a lot of viewers who are watching, who have heard this brief interview, I hope, you know, you will be you will get hold of a subscription form. The magazines are available in almost all jamaats. Fill up this application form. The cost is fairly nominal, and we will subscribe for it, or get one of your friends to subscribe towards it, and we'll start sending them copies.
Thank you very much.
Thanks so much indeed.
Have you seen him?
This is Mr. Sanvi Koko, who is our IT director for Review of Religions, and he does an immense amount of work on collating all the articles and then coordinating with all the authors and making sure, you know, everything is hunky-dory before the thing goes into the press. So in addition to that, he designs all our cover, you know, and he's the brains behind the entire Review of Religions. And he's also, you know, in charge of the circulation, sending out these copies, hard copies, to the various other places where these things get reproduced. So without him, you know, we would be stuck. So he's absolutely essential, and absolutely delighted that he's done this cover for us. This is one of his specimens.
Good.
Right. I'm with one of our member of the editorial board, and he is a specimen of Review of Religion, with some of the articles which get reproduced. And we have to work, all the members work as a team. So this is one of the product of the entire team working together. Jazakallah.
In previous years, this field was our overflow car park and would have been full by this time with cars from all over the continent. However, this year we've had to place the car park across the road in a field behind me. And you can see we've had to build a specially designed bridge to take people from the car park into this field on their way towards Jalsa Salana.
Flight
We're now outside the main gate of Islamabad. This year, it seems a little bit more calmer and less frantic than previous years. That's mainly due to the fact that the main car park is in the other field that we saw before. MTA is a truly international satellite TV station. We have studios located in many countries around the world. This exhibition will show us some of the output from these countries. On behalf of
and you're not going to copy mine, right? You have to make your own.
And of course, no exhibition about MTA would be complete without looking at some of the programs that are produced by MTA. Then we have the history of MTA over the years. Next we move on to the actual departments that run MTA International. We have the members of the board, then we have the production team. The next department is the scheduling department. Many of the people in the scheduling department actually helped put this together today. Then the transmission department, who upload all the images of MTA to the satellites and into your homes. The next department is the news and current affairs. And the last board is the translation department.